Hello students, today I have come up with the next part of the chapter Chemical Bonding from class 11 syllabus. Okay, so today I'll start with covalency or covalent compounds. Okay, so in today's video I'll start with covalency and I'll complete with the calculation of formal charge. So let's start with it. First is, you know that what is a covalent compound? You know that in covalent compounds, the electrons are shared between two or more atoms. For example, if I consider the structure of carbon dioxide, then you know that carbon has four valence electrons. Oxygen has six valence electrons. So you know that here carbon having four valence electrons and the two oxygens have six valence electrons. So, the oxygen will require two other electrons for completing its octet. This oxygen will also require two electrons to complete its octet. And this carbon requires four electrons to complete its octet. So, this carbon will share two of its electrons with this oxygen and two of its electrons with this oxygen. So, how the sharing will occur? It will share two of its electrons with this carbon, and the carbon will also share two of its electrons with this oxygen. The same thing will occur this side also. Okay, so after this, you know that two electrons result in the formation of a single bond. Therefore, four electrons will result in the formation of a double bond, resulting in the structure of carbon dioxide. And if you want to mention the lone pairs on this oxygen, you can also mention that. Okay? So, you know that like this, you have learnt till class 10 that how the structures are formed. I have drawn the Lewis structure, okay? So, this is how. I am not going to that part because those are not important now. Now, I will come to the important part, which is calculation of formal charge. How formal charge is calculated and what is formal charge? Now, what is a formal charge? Okay, I'll show that with an example. Like, this is the structure of ozone molecule. Okay, this is the structure of ozone molecule. So, normally, if an anion is present, what we do? We generally see the charge of the entire anion. But what is formal charge? Formal charge is the charge on each of the isolated atoms. The charge on this oxygen, the charge on this oxygen, and the charge on this oxygen. Individually, the charge on the individual atoms. That is known as a formal charge. Okay? So, how we will calculate the formal charge? There is a formula for that. Formal charge is equal to number of valence electrons of the isolated atom minus number of unshared electrons minus half into number of shared electrons. This is the formula of the formal charge. So, number of valence electrons of the isolated atom, number of unshared electrons minus half into number of shared electrons. For this, remember, you have to study the Lewis structures of all the compounds. Or the compounds which are there in your book, those are only the common compounds whose formal charge can be calculated. You have to know the Lewis structures of all the compounds given in the book. Okay, I'll come to the first example, which is ozone. Okay, I'm drawing the Lewis structure of ozone. Okay, this is the Lewis structure of ozone. I'll name this at all are since all are oxygen atoms, I'll name this as 1, this as 2, and this as 3. So the formal charge on each of this oxygen. First, let me come to the formal charge of the first oxygen. So formal charge of O1 means this one, middle one. Okay, so what is the number of valence electrons in an oxygen atom? The electronic configuration of oxygen is 2, 6. So the number of valence electrons for oxygen is 6 minus number of unshared electrons. See, this is the lone pair present. So this is, these two are the number of unshared electrons. 6 minus 2 minus half number of shared electrons. Now you know that each bond has 2 electrons. So this bond will have 2 electrons, this bond will have 2 electrons, and this bond will have 2 electrons. So 2 plus 2 plus 2, total number of shared electrons in oxygen is 6. Now you can ask a question that this oxygen atom is sharing only 1 electron. This oxygen atom is sharing only 1 electron in this bond, 1 electron in this bond, 1 electron in this bond. Then why we are writing the electron shared by the other oxygen atom also? Don't worry regarding that, because for that reason only I have given here half. In the formula it is given here half only for this reason only. So that the calculation becomes easier, we only calculate the shared electrons. That's why the half is given here. Okay, so if we calculate this, 3, 6 minus 2 minus 3, so it is plus 1. The formal charge of O2 means this oxygen. Number of valence electrons of oxygen is 6 only. Number of unshared electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of shared electrons, 2 for this bond, 2 for this bond. So it's 4. So it will become 6 minus 4 minus 2, 0. Formal charge of O3 means this oxygen. Number of valence electrons for oxygen is 6 only. Number of unshared electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. Number of shared electrons, 2 for this bond. So 6 minus 6, 0, minus 1, it becomes minus 1. So this is how you will calculate the formal charge of each of the individual atoms in a particular molecule or ion. This is for ozone. Okay, the next molecule I'll come to is sulfuryl chloride, SOCl2. SOCl2. So this is the Lewis structure of SOCl2. This is the Lewis structure of SOCl2. Now the formal charge of sulfur. So the number of valence electrons of sulfur. Sulfur is 2, 8, 6. So it is 6. Minus number of unshared electrons. See, unshared electrons 1, 2. Now half into number of shared electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 6 minus 2 minus 4, this will give you 0. So the formal charge on sulfur is 0 for this oxygen atom. Again, oxygen has number of valence electrons 6 minus number of unshared electrons 1, 2, 3, 4 minus half into number of shared electrons 1, 2, 3, 4. So 6 minus 4 minus this will come 2. So 6 minus 4 minus 2, that will also give you 0. Look at this, both the Cl atoms are same. Means the bonding in both the Cl atoms are similar. So both the Cl atoms will have same formal charge. So formal charge of Cl. Cl has number of valence electrons 2, 8, 7. Number of unshared electrons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Half into number of shared electrons 1, 2. So it will also come 0. Okay. So the formal charge on each of the atoms of sulfuryl chloride is 0. Okay, so now I'll come to two other examples of charged ions. Among them, the first one is carbonate. Okay, so this is the Lewis structure of carbonate. Okay, now we will calculate the formal charge of each of them. For carbon, number of valence electrons of carbon is 4. Number of unshared electrons 0. Number of shared electrons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 4 minus 4, it will be 0. Next is this carbon, this oxygen. Oxygen named as 1, and these two oxygens are same, so they will be named as 2 only. O1. Number of valence electrons for oxygen is 6. Number of unshared electrons 1, 2, 3, 4. And number of shared electrons 2 for this bond, 2 for this bond. 4. So 6 minus 4 minus 2, 0. Now these two oxygens will have the same formal charge because of the same bonding. So O2. The number of valence electrons for oxygen is 6. Number of shared electrons 2 for this single bond. Number of unshared electrons 6. Okay. Very sorry for this silly mistake. This is just the reverse calculation I have done. First, number of unshared electrons. No, that will be 6. And then I will come to the number of shared electrons, which is 2 for this bond. Please mark this, that is incorrect, which I have told you earlier. Okay. Means just for this one, I have made a silly mistake that I have reversed the numbers in these two cases. Okay. Only for this one. Okay, so 6 minus 6 is 0 and 1, so minus 1. So minus 1 is the charge for these two oxygens. Okay, so I'll come to the next one, which is the sulfate. This is the Lewis structure for sulfate. Okay. Now formal charge. For sulfur, number of valence electrons is 6. Number of unshared electrons, 0. Number of shared electrons, 2 for this bond, 2 for this bond, 2 for this bond and 2 for this bond. So 8. So what is the formal charge on sulfur? 6 minus 4 from this calculation, it will come plus 2. Okay. Next is for, see the bonding for all the oxygen atoms is same. So the formal charge of for all of them will be same only. So 6 minus unshared electrons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Shared electrons 2 for this single bond. So it is minus 1. So the formal charge on this on all the oxygen atoms of sulfate will be minus 1. This is for sulfate. Sulfate will be minus 1. So this is how you will calculate the formal charge of the individual atoms of the of a particular covalent molecule or an ion. Now, what is the need of calculation of this formal charge? See, actually, there are various Lewis structures for a particular molecule or ion. Various Lewis structures. So, among the Lewis structures, which Lewis structure we generally consider? We generally consider that Lewis structure which is the most stable one. Now, this formal charge of the individual atoms is required for finding out that which Lewis structure is the most stable Lewis structure of a particular molecule or ion. That's why formal charge is of importance only for the for finding out that feature of the Lewis structure for a particular molecule or ion is the most stable one. The Lewis structure which will have the lowest energy, that one will be most stable. Remember these things, that higher energy means unstable, lower energy means stable. So this formal charge of the individual atoms is used to generally find out the most stable Lewis structure among the all Lewis structures for a particular ion or molecule. Okay, so this is the basic use of formal charge. Okay, so this is this video is up till this. From the next video, I'll start with the other parts. Okay, thank you.